ओके, वी विल स्टार्ट नाउ। वी हैव टू टॉक अबाउट द नेक्स्ट इक्वेशन फॉर द सिंगल इलेक्ट्रोड पोटेंशियल। वी हैव टू डिराइव द नेक्स्ट इक्वेशन फॉर डिटरमिनेशन ऑफ सिंगल इलेक्ट्रोड पोटेंशियल। As you know, we have seen in the electrochemistry, we are going to use the cell. Okay, cell is consist of the two things. One half, two half cells, means two different electrodes. It has. Okay, and for this particular, we have to derive the Nernst equation to find out the EMF or say that potential difference across this particular cell. First of all, we will talk about the single electrode potential. For this purpose, we will consider the general reduction reaction of the metal ion on the surface of the cathode. In the general reaction, you can write down Mn plus aqueous plus n electron will gives you the metal solid. Reversible alloy is there. Okay, Mn plus aqueous plus n number of electron will gives you the metal solid. You know, reduction is nothing but the that particular species will acquire the electron and get from the their neutrals come to their neutral state. Means if one species is having the n plus charge and n number of electrons are coming from the any source, at that time that charge will become neutral and it will get reduced. The equilibrium constant K or Qp, equilibrium constant can be denoted by the K or Qp. You know the quotient of the reaction, that that is a Qp is nothing but a quotient. Quotient is nothing but the equilibrium constant is given by the relation. For this particular reaction, you have to write this particular equilibrium constant K or say Qp, which is given by, you know, the activity of the product side divided by the activity of the reactant side. Means activity of metal solid divided by the activity of this particular that whatever the metal ion present in the aqueous solution. Okay, since as we know, the activity of this particular solid is always the unity, and that's why AMS is always equal to 1. Therefore, Qp is equal to, now we can put, instead of activity of the metal, we will substitute the 1. This Qp is equal to 1 upon activity of the Mn plus aqueous. Then, the pre-energy changes. You know, every reaction, it has their own energy. Means we can say that everything has its own energy, that we have already seen free energy. Free energy change associated with the above reversible reaction is given by the equation. In the last semester, we talk about the free energy, Gibbs free energy, and the Helmholtz free energy. Here we are talking about the Gibbs free energy. Delta G is equal to delta G zero plus RT ln K. This is the equation number 3. Then the free energy changes are related to the EMF of the reversible cell, as you know, delta G is equal to minus NFE M Mn plus. Here, single electrode is there. That's why the delta G is equal to minus NFE M Mn plus. Then delta G is zero is equal to minus NFE zero M Mn plus. This is the equation number 4. On substituting this equation number 4 in equation number 3, we will get, we have to substitute this equation number 4 in the equation number 3. Therefore, instead of delta G, there will be the minus NFE MMN plus is equal to delta G0. Instead of delta G0, there will be the minus NFE0 MMN plus plus RT ln K. Then divide the equation 5 by minus NF to the both side of this equation. You will get such equation minus NFE MMN, MMN plus divided by minus NF is equal to minus NFE zero MMN plus divided by minus NF plus RT divided by minus NF ln K. NF will get cancelled, minus sign will get cancelled for this two term. then what will happen here in the next emmn plus is equal to e0 mmn plus minus rt ln k. This another you will get, you know, this emn plus will left is equal to e0 mmn plus minus, because rt here it is a plus sign, but in the denominator there is a minus nf, that's why minus rt nf ln k. Therefore, you will get the another equation, mmn plus is equal to e0 mmn plus minus rtnf ln 1 upon activity of the mn plus aqueous, because that k, that is nothing but the qp, which is given by the equation number 2, 1 upon amn plus aqueous. This is the equation number 6. After, we are unable to solve this natural log, we have to convert that log into the log to the base 10. For this purpose, we have to multiply this term by the 2.303. Means that you will get another equation, emmn plus is equal to e0 mmn plus minus 203 rt by nf into the log to the base 10, 1 upon activity of mn plus aqueous. This is the equation number 7. Then at 298 Kelvin, you know R is a gas constant, temperature is a 298, F is a 9650 Faraday, and after putting all this value, you will get another equation, that is a emmn plus is equal to e0 mmn plus minus 0.0596 by n log to the base 10, 1 upon amn plus aqueous. This is your Nernst equation for single electrode potential. This is a very simple equation. Based on this particular thing, we will apply this, we will determine the Nernst equation for the Daniell cell also. Explain the application of the Nernst equation in the study of the galvanic cell. You know, galvanic cell, simple example is the zinc and the copper cell that already we have seen for the number of times. This is Nernst equation, is the basic equation in the treatment of the galvanic cell. The change in the free energy of the reactant is equal to electrical work done, which is given by delta G is equal to minus E cell into NF, that already we have seen. Then where N is the number of electrons, F is the Faraday, which values is the 96500. Consider a reversible cell. Here we are talking about the Daniell cell. The example, galvanic cell example is the Daniell cell. The cell reaction is zinc solid plus copper 2 plus aqueous. Reversible arrow is there. Zinc 2 plus aqueous plus copper solid. Here number of electrons are 2. Because see, on the copper there is a 2 plus charge, and on the zinc same 2 plus charge. Means N is equal to, number of electrons involved is equal to 2. The equilibrium constant K of the reaction is given by, now we have to talk about the equilibrium constant, that is activity of the product divided by the activity of the reactant. Here in the product side, there is the activity of Zn2 plus aqueous into activity of copper solid divided by activity of zinc solid into activity of Cu2 plus aqueous. This is the equation number 1. Then since activity of solid already we have seen, which is always equal to unity, therefore activity of zinc solid is equal to activity of copper solid is equal to 1. We will put for this particular thing 1. Then we will get K is equal to QP, and K is equal to activity of zinc 2 plus aqueous divided by activity of Cu2 plus aqueous. This is the equation number 2. The free energy change associated with the reversible reaction is given by the equation delta G is equal to delta G0 plus RT ln K. This is the equation number 3 that already we have seen this thing. Same procedure is that the free energy changes are related to the EMF of the reversible cell, as that already we have seen delta G is equal to minus NFE and delta G0 is equal to minus NFE0. This is the equation number 4. On substituting equation number 4 in the equation number 3, we will get the same thing, minus NFE is equal to minus NFE0 plus RT ln K. Divide equation number 5 by the minus NF. Same thing we will get. Minus NFE MMN plus. You can take MMN plus by mistake. I keep there. There should not be the MMN plus. Minus NFE divided by minus NF is equal to minus NFE 0 divided by minus Na plus RT divided by minus Nf ln K. You will get simply E cell is equal to E0 cell minus RT ln K. And E cell is equal to E0 cell minus 2.303 RT Nf log to the base 10 K. You can substitute for the K. You will get E cell is equal to E0 cell minus 2.303 RT by Nf log to the base 10. Activity of zinc 2 plus iron in aqueous form divided by activity of CO2 plus in aqueous form. Then after at 298 Kelvin, again same equation, you will get E cell is equal to E0 cell minus 0.05916 divided by N log to the base 10. Activity of zinc 2 plus iron in the aqueous form divided by activity of CO2 plus iron in the aqueous form. This is the NOT equation for the Daniell cell. This is the example of the galvanic cell. Okay, Daniell cell is the example of the galvanic cell. Very simple derivation are there. You have to prepare simultaneously in the exam from these two equations. One equation will be there if the subjective exam is there. Otherwise, if the MCQ is there, then this the whatever the terminology, how the free energy is related to the electrical work done, or say EMF, that may be there. Well, what is that value of the Faraday? Okay, then what is the example of the galvanic cell? How this Nernst equation will be there? Okay, identify the Nernst equation for the single electrode potential and identify the Nernst equation for the galvanic cell, or say Daniell cell. This question will be there. I think so. All you got? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then I am stop this sharing and thank you.